Nada. Okay, baik. Hai, Assalamualaikum. Good morning to all students. Okay. Baik, kita mulakan kelas kita dengan kita akan discuss dulu latihan yang cikgu dah bagi in previous class. Okay. Okay. Baik, kenapa cikgu kata jawapan awak kebanyakannya tak tepat? Okay, bukannya cikgu kata salah. Cikgu tahu awak mungkin awak rujuk pada ada answer. Okay, awak rujuk pada answer. Jawapan dia RM57. Berapa sen dah? Okay. Alright. Ini yang cikgu nak bagi ni adalah jawapan yang tepat lah. Okay, kenapa cikgu kata jawapan yang tepat? Sebab kita apply apa yang kita dah belajar. Okay. Kita apply apa yang kita dah belajar tentang credit card. About credit card, macam mana dia akan charge interest, okay. In previous class, cikgu dah explain yang credit card statement will be issued to card holder every month. Okay, jadi awak kena calculate, okay. Awak perlu calculate interest monthly. Okay, monthly by using daily basis. Okay. Alright, now cikgu refer pada exercise yang sebelum ni ya. Okay. Jadi, cikgu tak kata awak buat salah. Mungkin awak buat itu berdasarkan apa yang awak faham. Okay, dan apa based on information given. Okay. Alright, jawapan yang awak bagi tu tak berapa nak tepat kalau kita tengok balik pada konsep yang kita dah belajar. Okay, yang awak apply tu adalah untuk simple interest. Okay, yang awak dah belajar tu. Kalau credit card is actually kita perlu kira based on daily basis dan kita kena calculate every month. Okay, dan setiap bulan, okay, setiap bulan dia akan issue statement tu, akan keluarkan statement kepada card holder. Okay, kita bincang dulu tentang apa yang jawapan yang sepatutnya. Kalau betul-betul awak faham apa jawapan yang sepatutnya. Okay, kalau siapa bagi jawapan yang macam cikgu bagi ni, memang cikgu akan bagi dekat dia band yang tinggi lah, tahap penguasaan yang tinggi. Okay, sebab dia betul-betul faham. Okay, but based on the question, okay, credit card statement, the total amount payable ataupun this one is the outstanding balance 2018, RM 2018. Okay, question A, this one is the direct question. Okay, you have to find what is the minimum payment. Okay, what is the minimum payment untuk this card holder. Okay, for that month. Okay. Okay, yang dia dah bagi kat sini 5%. Okay, memang 5% lah untuk minimum payment, 5%. Semua awak jawab dengan betul lah, awak dapat RM190. RM190 for the minimum payment. Okay. Memang untuk calculate the amount untuk question B, the bank charge an interest of 12%. Okay, di sini dia dah bagi ini adalah untuk interest. Okay, ataupun the finance charge per annum. Okay, calculate the interest charge on the balance. Okay, charge on the balance in 3 months. Okay, kan cikgu dah explain yang kita perlu kira monthly, setiap bulan. Okay, macam mana nak calculate? Di sini dia tak bagi tahu berapa date from the interest free period. Okay, dia tak bagi, so kita assume kita kira tak ada lah. Okay, kalau dia bagi kat situ, in dalam example yang kita dah pernah buat, kita akan kira berapa hari selepas interest free period perlu kena charge. Okay, alright, ni macam mana how you can answer the question. Alright, first state dulu, we assume that the card holder only make minimum payment every month. Okay, jawapan dia boleh pelbagai ya. Kalau awak kata dia tak buat minimum payment, jawapan dia akan jadi macam lain lah. Okay, yang ni we assume that the card holder make minimum payment every month. Okay, so the first month. Okay, for the first month, okay, RM 2018, this one is the outstanding balance based on the credit card statement. Then they make the minimum payment based on the answer question number one, 190 cent. Okay, then you get this one, the new outstanding balance for that month after he make the payment, the minimum payment. Okay, and then we have to find what is the interest charge for that month. Okay, for that month means the first month lah, the first month tu. Okay, so kat sini dia tak bagi berapa hari, what month. Okay, so kita assume kita ambil in months lah, 1 month. Okay, sebab tu this one you divide by 12. Otherwise we divide by 365. Ada student yang buat, yang cikgu ingat Fahana ada buat, dia divide by 365. Fahana kelas lain kan? Fahana mana 383. Okay, dia buat divide by 365. Tapi kita tak tahu nak times berapa sebab kita tak tahu which month. Okay, so that's why kat sini, okay, yang cikgu tunjuk calculation ini, divide by 12 based on 12 months and then kita darab dengan once. Okay, alright. Okay, and then multiply with the new outstanding balance after he make the payment. After he make the payment, so the interest for the first month is RM19.17. Okay, ini untuk first month. The second month, calculate dia based on, okay. So kita akan dapat new balance dulu. New outstanding balance. Okay. Kita tambah ke interest tu, kita perlu tambah dengan the previous outstanding balance. So the new outstanding balance for the next month is RM1,936.27. Okay. Ini yang kita akan guna this value untuk the next month. Untuk kira the next month. Okay, so this one is the calculation for the second month. Okay, this one is the calculation for the second month. The minimum payment is 5%. Kan, tadi kita dah kata, we assume that he only make minimum payment. So kita nak tengok berapa the minimum payment yang dia buat for the second month. Okay, for the second month, the minimum payment akan berbeza. Different compared to the first month. Because the new balance dah berbeza. Okay, so the minimum payment for the second month is RM96.81. Alright, so you calculate the new outstanding balance after he make the minimum payment. So you get the new outstanding balance and then you calculate, after that you calculate the interest. Okay, so dapat interest for the second month pun dah lain, RM18.42. Okay, cikgu takkan tunjuk in full, cikgu nak awak cuba buat for the third month and then awak cuba calculate balik what is the total interest for the 3 months. Okay, first month, the interest for the first month, okay, this value tambah dengan interest for the second month, this value. Okay, alright, lepas tu cari untuk the third month. Okay, dapat tak answer yang macam cikgu bagi? Okay, alright. Itu untuk the previous exercise yang cikgu dah bagi supaya awak faham, ya. Cikgu explain ni supaya awak faham. Okay, betul-betul faham, betul-betul konsep untuk credit cards. Alright. Hari ni kita akan masuk new learning standard. Okay, you can refer your textbook. Okay. Page berapa, eh? Yang ni page, refer to textbook, page. Sekejap. Mana dia? Okay, textbook page 77. Okay, refer your textbook page 77. Okay, make sure awak ada pen, ada kertas, okay, test pad untuk awak catatkan. Catatkan the important information, ah. Alright. And then nanti nak kira perlukan calculator. Make sure dah get ready dengan apa keperluan-keperluan untuk kita punya pelajaran hari ini. Okay, the learning standard for today is to solve, okay, problems involving credit cards. Okay, problem solving involving credit cards. Okay, sebelum ni kita dah belajar tentang credit cards, the advantage and disadvantage, impact of minimum payment and then impact of apa ni, late payment, okay, dan sebagainya. So sekarang ni kita nak apply in this problem solving question. Alright? Okay. how do you solve problems involving credit cards, the use of credit cards, okay? Credit cards holder should be aware of the advantage or disadvantage of credit cards yang kita dah discuss in previous class. Okay, several factors have to be taken into account before using credit cards, such as the balance of existing limits and then current cash flow and so on. Okay, current cash flow means that your own money lah, berapa yang awak ada, nanti berapa yang awak nak kena bayar dan sebagainya. Alright, now kita tengok the example 17. Okay, look at example 17. Okay, Miss Chin wants to buy a French-made handbag online. Okay, dia nak beli secara online. She surf the internet and find two interesting promotions. Okay, macam awak tengok Shopee ke Lazada ke, awak akan compare price first. Okay, alright. Okay, kat sini dia ada jumpa untuk two slow sikit. Okay, so di sini ada Abi, slow. Okay, sorry ya. Alright, so di sini ada two interesting promotions. Okay, there are two interesting promotions. Ada company L. Okay, company L in Singapore offers promotional price SGD 250. Okay, for order outside Singapore, SGD 50 shipping charges apply. Okay, kat sini company L ni dia offer harga handbag ni dengan nilai SGD 250. Okay, SGD 250. Okay, awak boleh dengar cikgu jelas ke? Awak dengar cikgu sekat-sekat?
Jelas.
Jelas, tak ada terputus-putus ah?
Tak ada cikgu.
Okay, baik, masih. Okay. Ini company L, so awak kena faham sekarang ni dia offer SGD 250 for that handbag. And then kita ni, Miss Chin ni in Malaysia. Okay, in Malaysia dia nak purchase. Kalau dia nak purchase outside, maksudnya dia nak beli daripada Singapore, dia kena akan ada shipping charge SGD 50. Okay, SGD 50. Alright, and then company company V in Malaysia offer promotional price of $799. Okay, sekarang kita tak boleh nak compare lagi. Why kita tak boleh compare lagi? Because we do not know. Sebab kita nak buat comparison, kita kena pastikan unit dia sama. Okay, make sure unit dia sama. Sekarang ni unit dia satu Singapore dollar, satu lagi dalam RM. Then delivery fee, delivery is free for all orders to local address. Okay, maksudnya kalau dia beli daripada company V, okay, dia tak perlu bayar untuk shipping charge, okay, delivery charge ataupun postal charge. Okay, so Miss Chin intends to make payment by credit card. Dia nak guna credit card. And she understand that the bank will charge an additional 1% on each transaction from abroad. Maksudnya kalau dia guna credit card, ini salah satu daripada disadvantage jugalah untuk credit card, dia akan ada additional charge. Okay, tapi kalau yang ini yang based on this example, dia akan kena additional charge kalau dia buat transaction from abroad. Maksudnya kalau dia beli daripada company L by using credit card, dia akan kena 1% charge, additional charge. Tapi kalau dia nak guna credit card untuk beli daripada company V, dia tak kena lah sebab this one the local company. Alright. Okay, dan dia bagi kat sini untuk currency. Okay, RM1 is equals to SGD 0.34. Okay, dalam this question, you have to apply apa yang dah belajar dalam proportion. Okay, okay. RM1 over, kalau kita guna proportion, RM1 over Singapore dollar 0.34. Ini kita nak guna proportion. Macam mana kita nak kira in, kita nak kira tadi ni harga yang ni dalam Singapore dollar. So kita nak tahu dalam RM berapa, so kita guna proportion method X over SGD 250. Kita akan apply this one. Okay. Alright, untuk cari berapa harga that handbag, kemudian kita nak cari berapa harga untuk shipping charge in RM. Alright. Okay, look at the question. As a wise consumer, which offer should Miss Chin choose? Justify your answer. Okay. So, first kita akan kira dulu berapa promotional price from the company L. Okay, guna yang cikgu dah tunjuk atas ni tadi. Okay, untuk how to find the promotional price in RM. Okay. Alright. So macam mana nak selesai ni, cikgu tunjuk outside workings dulu ah. This one kalau nak dapatkan X, okay, RM1 over SGD 0.34, you have to multiply by SGD 250 untuk dapatkan X. Okay, so untuk dapatkan promotional price is RM1 over SGD 0.34 multiplied by SGD 250. Okay, cuba calculate. Guna calculator, calculate berapa in RM. Apa? Dapat jawapan? Cuba klik. Kelas. Dapat apa? 1 over 0.34 multiply 250. So bagi dalam 2 decimal places, ya. Yeah, bagi dalam 2 decimal places RM 735.29. This one is the promotional price. Okay. Next we calculate what is the shipping charge. Okay, based on the statement based on the question given, the shipping charge is Singapore dollar berapa tadi? 50. Okay, so this one RM1 over SGD 0.34 you multiply by SGD 50. Okay, so berapa akan dapat? Yeah, RM147.06. Okay, 6 cents. You round off. Okay, round off. Okay. Okay, ada lagi dia kena charge lagi. Okay, selain daripada shipping charge, ada lagi additional charge on credit cards. Berapa persen? It is 1% based on what? Berapa? Berapa persen, 1% daripada berapa value dia? Kita kena tambahkan harga that handbag dengan the shipping charge, because bila dia nak buat payment, okay, dia nak buat payment mestilah dia kena bayar dua-dua sekali kan? Jadi kita akan tambahkan, okay, kita akan tambahkan this one, RM735.29 you plus dengan RM 100. Ni cikgu tak enough, tak ada cukup space lah. Kalau awak tulis in one line lah. Okay. Alright, then you calculate. Dapatkan value berapa. First you tambah dulu 735.29 you plus 147.06 and then multiply by 1%. So the additional charge is RM 8 ringgit. Betul tak ni? Awak dapat ni? 1%. Okay? 8 ringgit 82 sen. Ini adalah additional charge bila guna credit cards. So berapa actually the price paid for to have that handbag? Okay, so kita kena tambah all the charge lah. The promotional price, kemudian the shipping charge and then the credit card charge. Okay, so kita tambahkan RM735.29 you plus dengan shipping charge and plus dengan additional charge. Okay, so calculate berapa awak dapat. RM735.29 plus RM147 and then plus RM8.82. Eh, betul ke Kak Rohinah kira tu? Saya dapat lain? Awak dapat berapa yang lain? Jangan refer pada textbook, refer pada apa yang calculation yang cikgu tunjuk. Okay? Berapa? Awak dapat tak sama macam cikgu? Yang lain? Dapat. Okay, awak dapat RM891.17. Okay, this one is the answer. Okay, ini cara nak solve problem involving credit cards. Okay, ada soalan? Sebelum cikgu move to other parts. Takat ni ada soalan? Okay, kita belum habis lagi. Okay, tak habis lagi answer this one. Because apa? Kita baru cari untuk company L. Berapa price yang dia paid untuk company L? This one is kalau dia beli from company L. Okay, company from Singapore. So, total amount yang she will pay is RM891.17. Okay, now company V. The promotional price, check balik berapa promotional price is? RM799. Okay, so the promotional price is RM799. Okay, dan dia tak ada shipping. Shipping dia, delivery dia free because they beli from the local company. And then dia tak ada additional charge bila dia guna credit cards untuk local purchasing. Alright, so the total price to be paid is sama lah, RM799. Then you compare. You compare between the price yang dia akan pay. Satu daripada company L, satu lagi untuk dia pay untuk company V. So, yang mana yang perlu dia dia beli from company L or company V? As a wise consumer, mestilah dia akan beli from company V. Okay, because she can save more money. Walaupun mula-mula tu kita tengok harga promotional price, okay, promotional price dia memanglah kurang kat sini. Awak tengok kat sini value ni RM735, okay, compared to RM799 memanglah nampak dia murah, okay, but she have to incur more charges, okay, more charge, okay, shipping charge and additional charge on credit cards, okay. Alright, now kita akan masuk new learning standard. Okay, this one is the learning standard. Calculate the total amounts of loan repayment and installment with various interest rates and different loan period. Okay, sebelum ni we have learned about credit cards. Okay, kan kita dah belajar. Okay, credit credit is a facility to postpone payment. Okay, given by supplier. Okay, credit dia ada banyak. Okay, ada credit cards, credit facility ni ada credit cards, kemudian ada loan, bank loan. Okay, bank loan ni ada banyak pula, ada personal loan, ada housing loan, ada macam-macam loan. Okay, tapi yang sekarang ni kita akan refer untuk bank loan, kita akan tengok personal loan and then car loan. Okay, right. So macam mana nak kira loan, macam mana nak kira installment. Alright, itu yang kita akan belajar. Okay. Alright, konsep dia sama, okay, sama macam lebih kurang kita belajar savings, okay, tapi awak kena pay attention juga apa yang kita akan discuss this one. How do you calculate loan repayment and installment? Okay, sekarang ni ada loan repayment and installment. Loan repayment is the total loan. Okay, total loan yang dia kena bayar balik. Installment adalah monthly. Okay, berapa yang dia akan bayar setiap bulan. Okay, untuk installment ni dia ada period yang panjang. Okay, tempoh yang panjang. So kita kena tengok based on the what period for that loan. Okay, okay, tengok dalam textbook. Each loan will be charged interest on loan from the date the loan was released to the borrower. Okay, ha, dia bila release saja pada borrower untuk loan tu, dia akan kena, akan will be charged interest. Okay, interest will be charged. Okay, there are two calculation methods for loan. Okay, there are two calculation method for loan interest. Namely, flat interest rate and interest on balance. Kalau dalam saving, okay, untuk saving, apa yang awak dah belajar? Awak belajar simple interest and satu lagi compound interest. Okay, itu untuk saving. Untuk loan, okay, flat interest rate ni dia lebih kurang sama dengan simple interest. Okay, sebab formula dia sama. I equals to PRT. Okay, I equals to PRT untuk kira flat interest rate. Okay, kemudian untuk interest on balance, dia tak sama dengan compound interest. Okay, compound interest yang awak belajar dalam saving, dia tak sama dengan interest on balance. Okay, nanti kita akan tengok apa dia beza dia. Alright, okay, the total loan balance is the amount deducted from initial down payment plus the amount interest charge. Okay, nanti cikgu akan tunjukkan apa yang dimaksudkan dengan this paragraph. Okay, the monthly installment is the total amount paid by borrower to the bank every month to settle the balance of the loan. Okay, kita tengok sini dalam notes yang cikgu dah sedia. Loan interest ada two methods, okay, which is flat interest rate and interest on balance. Okay, make sure you take note this one. Loan interest can be calculate based on two methods, flat interest rate and interest on balance. Flat interest rate, okay, formula dia sama dengan simple interest, okay, PRT. Alright, interest on balance, cara calculate dia lain. Alright, okay, this one, apa yang dimaksudkan dengan that paragraph yang cikgu sebut tadi untuk total loan repayment. To find what is the total loan repayment, okay, awak perlu tambahkan, okay, purchase price. Okay, kalau katakan sekarang ni, katakan dia beli kereta lah. Okay, buy a car. Okay, the purchase price for the car, let's say 100,000. Okay, awak tinggi sangat. Okay, saya bagi contoh 80,000. Kereta apa dah dapat 80,000, tak tahulah kan. Okay, purchase price dia 80,000. Okay, normally down payment is 10%. Okay, 10%. Okay, ataupun bergantung kepada company yang jual tu lah. Okay, kemudian dia kena bayar down payment. Okay, kemudian the purchase price minus down payment and then you have to plus dengan interest untuk dapatkan berapa total repayment, total loan repayment, berapa yang dia perlu bayar. Okay, nanti kita akan tengok contoh soalan. Okay, untuk kira total loan repayment. Okay, and then to find the monthly installment, okay, to find the monthly installment, total loan repayment yang dah kira kat sini, okay, alright, perlu divide by the loan terms. Loan terms kena kira dalam months. Okay, untuk dapatkan, sebab kat sini kita kata monthly repayment, monthly installment. Monthly installment maksudnya dia kena bayar berapa balik kepada bank ikut setiap bulan. Dia ada fixed amount yang perlu bayar. Alright, untuk dapatkan monthly installment, total loan repayment divide by the loan term dan kita kena loan term tu dalam months. Kalau dia kata dia buat loan for 5 years, so 5 times 12, okay, 60 months lah. You have to divide by 60 months. Alright, now look at the example. Okay, Mrs. Lim bought a car, okay, worth RM80,000. This one is the purchase price. Okay, the purchase price. Okay, dia kata kat sini, okay, Mrs. Lim bought a car worth RM80,000 on credit. Maksudnya dia tak bayar secara cash. On credit maksudnya dia postpone the payment. Okay, dia berhutang lah ni, dia ada debt. Okay, alright. She pays 10% down payment. Ah, yang ni yang cikgu sebut tadi, normally down payment is 10%. Okay, normally. Okay, 10%. Macam kita belajar dalam apa ni, apa tajuk dia? Property, real property. Okay, ada kena bayar 10% down payment tu. Okay, 10% down payment, so berapa dia punya down payment? Okay, this one is 10% multiplied by the purchase price, 80,000. Okay, so the down payment is, alah tak muat. Down payment dia berapa kelas? RM?
8,000.
Yeah, 8,000. Okay, thank you Nawal. Selalu respon dengan saya. Okay, okay, saya tak kesunyian bila ada Nawal. Okay. Alright, sambung balik baca. She pays 10% down payment and the balance is payable in installment over 6 years. So the loan term is 6 years. Ini dalam tahun. Okay, dalam bulan berapa? Kalau berapa kira berapa months? 6 times 12 months. So berapa months? Berapa?
72.
Ya, terima kasih siapa tadi. Tadi dengar suara lelaki. Okay, macu je suara tu. Okay, 72 months. Okay, 72 months. Ini untuk the loan term. Berapa tempoh period of the loan? Okay, 6 years. Alright. Sekarang ni dia guna flat interest rate. Dia akan sebut lah sama ada dia guna based on interest on balance or flat interest rate. The flat interest rate is imposed by bank 4% per annum. This one is the rate, interest rates. Okay, what is the amount of repayment? Okay, amount of repayment maksudnya berapa total loan dia lah. Okay, yang dia perlu bayar balik. And monthly installment payable by Mrs. Lim. Nah, kat sini banyak nak kena calculate. You have to calculate banyak benda kat sini. Alright. So refer balik pada formula yang cikgu dah bagi. Okay, the total loan is equals to purchase price minus down payment plus dengan interest. Okay, so kita akan kira loan amount. Okay, berapa loans amount dulu? Kita akan kira loan amount. RM80,000 is the purchase price. You minus dengan 10% down payment. Okay, 10% down payment. 8,000. Okay, so the loan amount is RM, is it 72,000? Betul? 72,000 is the loan. Okay, ini adalah loan amount. Okay, thank you Afika. Okay, this one is the loan amount. 72,000. Belum campur interest lagi. Okay, ni jumlah yang digunakan loan untuk pay the car. Alright, 8,000 dia guna duit dia sendiri. Lagi 70,000 dia buat pinjaman dengan bank lah. Okay, now kita nak kira interest. Interest is PRT. Okay, interest is PRT, tapi sekarang ni untuk kira PRT ni T dia dalam years. Okay, so PRT, ya cikgu tulis kat sini PRT. Principal means that berapa loans yang dia buat is 72,000. You times dengan rate 4%. You times dengan berapa tahun dia buat loan? 6 years. Okay, then calculate. Kira 72,000 multiplied by 4% times 6. Okay, so the interest, betul ke cikgu kira ni? Interest is 17,280. Awak dapat this one?
Dapat.
Dapat, Afiqah. Okay. So, kat sini dah dapat interest. Ini adalah total interest untuk 6 years. Okay, untuk 6 tahun tu total interest dia 17,280. Alright. So, kita akan kira total berapa balik repayment yang dia, berapa repayment, total repayment yang dia perlu buat. Okay, so kita tambahkan the loan amount 72,000. You plus dengan interest 17,280. Okay, so kita plus dengan 72,000. Okay, so the total loan repayment is 89,220. Okay, this one is the total loan repayment. Jumlah yang dia perlu bayar balik kepada bank. Alright. Next, we calculate the monthly installment. Okay, monthly installment is the total loan repayment divide by berapa? Berapa months? Tadi dah kira?
72.
Yeah, 72 months. Ishan Tirans. Okay, 72 months. Okay, so we divide by 72. So, the monthly installment is RM1,240. Okay, this one is the monthly installment. Maksudnya the fixed amount yang Mrs. siapa tadi, Mr. Lim, Mrs. Lim ke? Dia perlu bayar balik kepada bank setiap bulan. RM1,240. Okay, boleh follow cikgu? Ada soalan setakat ni? Tak ada. Senyap tu tak ada. Alright. Kita tengok another example untuk loan. Okay, ini untuk flat interest loan. Alright. Encik Azlan obtain a personal loan. Tadi kita tengok car loan. Okay, car loan tadi dia ada down payment. Okay, untuk personal loan tak ada down payment ya. Personal loan tu terus kita dapat dia punya total loan. Lepas tu kita kena tambahkan dengan interest. Okay. Alright. The Encik Azlan obtain personal loan 10,000 from Bank Mulia with interest rate 4% per annum. The repayment is 7 years. Okay. So macam kita jawab yang dalam tajuk saving. Okay. This one as the principal. This one is the rate and this one is the time. Okay. The period of the loan. Alright. What is the monthly installment to be paid by Encik Azlan? Yang ni senang je sebab awak dah ada prior knowledge about interest. Macam kita belajar saving. Okay. So interest kita akan kira 4% times dengan, okay. Kat sini soalan ni dia tak sebut flat interest ataupun interest on balance. So kita assume this one is the flat interest. Okay. Kalau soalan silent tak sebut apa interest, what types of interest, kita akan kata ini adalah flat interest. Okay, so 4% you multiply by RM, the loan is 10,000. Okay, okay, PRT, saya tunjuk ikut susunan. Okay, P, interest is PRT, PRT. Okay, so interest is 10,000, you multiply by rate is 4% and then multiply by the 7 years. Okay. So dapat berapa kat sini? 10,000 multiplied by 4%. 2800. Okay, this one is the interest, total interest for 7 years. Okay, then total loans is, the loans is 10,000. You plus dengan, okay, yang ni cikgu dah bagi formula ni ya, P plus PRT untuk dapatkan the total loans. Okay, plus dengan 2,800. So this one is RM 12,800 for the total loan repayment. Okay, untuk total loan repayment $12,800. Then kita kira monthly installment. Question asks you to find monthly installment. Okay, macam mana nak dapatkan monthly installment? RM $12,800 is the total loan. You divide by berapa?
84 months.
Why? Kenapa kita kena ambil 84 months?
7 years.
Okay, untuk dapatkan monthly installment kena divide by months, total months untuk the loan terms. Okay, so berapa tadi? 84. Okay, so 12,800 you divide by 84. Okay, the monthly installment betul ke dapat this figure? 152.38. Okay, thank you. Alright, senang saja untuk kira yang loan, personal loan ni kira senang saja. Okay, ada soalan nak tanya? Simonis ada nak soalan, nak tanya ke? Tengok on mic. Okay, kalau tak ada, kita teruskan dengan exercise. Okay, ini exercise ni awak perlu buat dalam modul tuntas A+. Okay, page 29 and 30. Question 1 until question 4. Okay, ada soalan nak tanya kot tak jelas? Okay, saya ulang balik. Ini adalah exercise yang awak perlu buat. Okay, dan awak hantar dalam channel nanti. Okay, cikgu akan sediakan ruang untuk awak hantar exercise dalam channel. Okay, so itu sahaja untuk hari ini. Hari Rabu kita akan jumpa balik. Betul? Hari Rabu? Kelas? Betul ke? Betul. Siapa Vinod nak jumpa hari Rabu ni ya?
Cikgu Rabu ke Siti ke?
Oh cepat.
Rabu besar dia cikgu.
Oh cepat je kalau cuti. No Ariana? Ha? Okay, so hari Rabu kita tak ada PDPR, kita tak ada kelas. Okay, so bila pula kita akan jumpa? Kita akan jumpa balik selepas cuti penggal. Haa, ni Q baru masuk Q. Orang dah habis kelas, awak baru masuk Q. Tak apa Q, nanti awak tengok yang cikgu hantar record nanti. Haa, nanti yang penting Q dah masuk kelas. Okay. Right, so kita akan jumpa balik berapa hari bulan pula lah. Okay, bulan 6 nanti. Okay, so stay safe, stay at home. Okay, buatlah kerja, buat ulang kaji. Alright, okay, bye.
Terima kasih, cikgu.
Terima kasih, cikgu.
Okay,
sama-sama. Terima kasih, cikgu.
Sama-sama.
Terima kasih, cikgu.
Ya.
Terima
kasih, cikgu. Ya, sama-sama. Ni seorang lagi. Nabil baru masuk. Orang dah habis dah Nabil. Okay Nabil, nanti tengok yang record ya Nabil.